players eager. Referee checks his watch, and we're underway in the 2015 Asian Cup final between Australia and South Korea. Former Socceroo Robbie Slater alongside for the call. What a crowd, what a night in prospect.
And what an amazing 2.5 weeks that culminates here in Sydney, and it couldn't be set up any better. The two very best teams in the tournament. And what's on the line? Well, neither of these countries, of course, have won it. So a massive prize at the end of tonight's game. Of course, Australia, this is only their third appearance. Beaten in the final 4 years ago against Japan, quarterfinals in 2007.
Here's Jason Davidson winning that battle with Aziz Baige for the left-back spot. And he's onside, Tim Cahill. Clever ball from Leckie. Tries to stand it up to the back post. And normally it's the other way around. The winger's trying to tee up Tim Cahill.
They just spun into a bit of space there. Quatte Wei straight onto Chowdhury saying, you've got to track that run in the inside channel.
Bond was one of the goal scorers in the semi against Iran. Well won back by Luongo. Leckie's on the move, so is Cahill. Leckie got there first ahead of Chowdhury. Hasn't scored yet in the tournament, Matthew Leckie. And the follow-up work from Milligan wins the free kick for Australia.
Yeah, just left his foot in there, John Kyung Soo. A little acceleration for the first time from Australia. Luongo with nearly the perfect pass to Leckie. Well, good defending. Don't forget, no one scored against this team in this tournament. Haven't yet conceded the goal. Australia probably coming the closest in their group stage match. A terrific performance from Kim Jin-hyun, the South Korean goalkeeper.
And now you'd imagine it's Mille Edinet to pack some gunpowder behind this one.
The noise levels reaching a crescendo from those in green and gold, so desperate to see a home win here tonight. The Korean fans responding. Mille Edinet over the wall and just over the top of the goal. Some on this near touchline celebrating, thinking it was a goal.
Very close. Nice placement. Keeper, I'd reckon, beaten. I'm not quite sure that Kim Jin-hyun had that covered, but it just dropped over the bar. Keeper looked all sorts to me.
Well, it's back to the early stages of the Asian Cup, isn't it? They were like this a little bit. That one's going to have to be quick against Kuwait, and then subsequently for a little time against Oman at this venue. So they found their feet, found their rhythm, and found the back of the net, crucially. Here's Kim Jin-soo venturing forward from left fullback. Late challenge by Luongo. Free kick South Korea. Promising situation
very,
again.
Very dangerous. I just thought Mas Luongo could have stuck with him a little longer. And he saw the opportunity to win the ball. And it was his decision to make, but it came unstuck. And now his team's under pressure again. They're a big physical team. Scoring from set pieces. They haven't scored a lot during this competition, but set pieces have always been dangerous for South Korea.
Lee Jung-kyup, of course, got them on their way against Iraq in the semis from a free kick. Similar position, different side. Via the aerial route. It's drilled in. Oh, the header from Quatte Hui. He feels he probably should have done a bit better with that. And I'm inclined to agree with him.
He definitely should have, Simon, you're right. He's made great space. It's a free header at the front post. Trent Sainsbury was with him, but he couldn't keep with him close enough. That's a really great chance in a cup final.
Milligan, beautiful first time ball. Picks out Cruz, who releases first time. Tim Cahill, beaten away by Kim Jin-hyun. First chance for Timmy Cahill. And he stung the gloves of Kim Jin-hyun. Temperatures rising in Sydney.
But this was brilliant intuitive play from Cruz to Timmy Cahill. Now, Robbie Cruz was away and he instinctively looked to centre the ball as early as he could, and Timmy Cahill knew it was coming. And he jinked for the far post with half a step, and then he made a beeline for the near post with a good first touch and a stinging shot.
Luongo's corner, Cahill leaps, can't reach it. Up in the air by Ki Sung Yong and away by Cha Du Ri. And now perhaps the counter is on. Hoiked forward by Nam Tae Hui. And it's Matt Ryan out some 40 metres to play auxiliary sweeper. Heat's been applied by both teams. It escapes Cahill, but Luongo gives chase. Second favourite always to Kim Jin-hyun.
Well, there is plenty for both sets of fans to enjoy here so far. In
the shoulder. He's within his right surf. Letting that one go as well. Lee Jung-kyung almost stole that. Instead, it's with Park Ju-ho on the left. Nam Tae-hee twisting hither and thither and waiting for the runner, who is Kim Jin-soo, who clips it towards Son Heung-min. And it flashes just wide of that right-hand upright. What a move by the South Koreans.
Well, what about the speed? What about the speed of Kim Jin-soo to join the attack and just dinks it to the back stick? That's close. Incredibly close from Son Heung-min. Great action. Wonderful play, South Korea. The first basic error, like that return from the throw-in that they've made all half. Australia have made plenty of such unforced errors. And that's the first from South Korea, which is why they've enjoyed the ascendancy.
It's a real shank off the boots of Kim Jin-hyun, and Cha Du Ri can't keep it alive. He's had just one real moment of action in this first period, beating away that Timmy Cahill effort. Otherwise, it's South Korea that's been on the front foot. Can Australia finish the half on top? Luongo! Oh, my goodness! Massimo Luongo! First blood in the Asian Cup final to Australia! Against the run of play, it might be, but they will say, who cares? What a hit! What a moment for the Roos!
Well, look at the pass from Sainsbury. Again, the pass from Trent Sainsbury to bypass opposing players and put a teammate in the advantage position. And then Mas Luongo receives the ball with a half turn, rolls it towards the target, and lets rip from 20 yards. It's a beauty on cup final night from Mas Luongo. An absolute beauty!
And look at the smile on the face of Ange Postecoglou. He arrowed it into the corner of the goal. Trying to turn clear of Cruz. That's not a great ball. Can Australia control it and launch a counter? Here's Matt Leckie. Only has Cahill as an option. Australia slow to support this attack. Leckie might not need any. Inside the penalty area, Cahill is back central now. Leckie's just saying to a teammate, please help me out. Now Franich to curl it in. All a little haphazard, that.
First time in the tournament that the Socceroos in twos and threes haven't been able to break away from their opponents and make space. This has just been incredibly impressive by South Korea. What a performance so far. And Australia, despite the fact that they're leading, just cannot settle into the game. Enormous effort.
Almost an hour played in Sydney. Still Australia 1, Korea 0. Luongo's corner, Cahill leaps. But it was Sainsbury. To Lee Kyun-ho. That delivery from Park Ju-ho. Now Cruz can turn and run with pace. Oh, he slipped. Just at the vital moments. But the intent was good.
Devastatingly unlucky. And Robbie Cruz was through.
I mean, look at Cha Du Ri here. Still he goes on, Cha Du Ri. Son Heung-min outside him. And the break falls kindly for Australia.
You just can't take your eyes off this. Because now it's Matthew Leckie away. Look how stretched the field is. Big test for South Korea now, physically.
Nobody's trapped Luongo. He couldn't score a second, could he? Driven back by Kwak Tae-hui. Juric leaves it for Davidson. Luongo. inviting Davidson to come forward again, and they accept the offer of a throw, Australia, by the new man, Han Kook-young. And they find the right cross, and it might just squirt in favour of a South Korea, but Matt Ryan drops gratefully on the ball. Australia survive another foray.
And they're in this situation now, Postecoglou with 20 to go. Robbie Cruz has made way for James Troisi.
Punted forward by Kim Jung-kwon.
That's a high boot, surely.
Here's the chance. Son Heung-min inside the box. They've scored! Son Heung-min, it's stoppage time! Oh, what drama, what joy for South Korea! It still might be, of course, but South Korea have a lifeline through Son Heung-min.
Well, the pressure is finally told. And this is just the tail end. It's a great finish from Son, the superstar of Bayer Leverkusen. Well, my question about that is a high foot. And Son's broken clear, and he gets it through the narrowest of corridors. Well, you can hardly begrudge them a goal. They've been sensational tonight. And we're set for extra time.
Davidson. Oh, not that through. Lee Kyung-ho, and they find Tommy Urich. This looks promising for Australia. Luongo, with Milligan arriving. Luongo tries to chip it in, and Kim Jin-hyun at full stretch. Gets it away. Here's yet an act to return. It's disappointing.
Yeah.
Deep inside the final minutes of the first half of added time, extra time, I should say. And here's Luongo. Mackay. Option on the right is Juric. Was that a shot? Was it a cross? Still he goes on, scrapping for it with Kim Jin-soo. Did the fullback bring him down? First time, maybe even second time. Still we go on. Juric has wriggled his way clear. Chance! Goal! For Australia! James Troisi! Can that win the Asian Cup? Oh, boy! Listen to this! Tommy Juric was backed into a corner, but somehow he found the gap. And James Troisi was the jolly on the spot. Australia lead again.
Well, we needed, Australia needed Tommy Juric to get involved in the game. Not only does he get involved, but he sticks to the task. He fights for possession. He gets rid of two opponents. He squares the ball into the penalty area. It's Kim Jin-hyun who can only palm that ball into the on-rushing James Troisi. That is sensational work from Tommy Juric. And the right foot of James Troisi. It couldn't do the business in Brisbane in game three of the group stages, but it's done the business here in the final of the Asian Cup.
For South Korea, is there one final chance to maybe take this epic final to penalties? They thread it through, same sort of position from where Son Heung-min scored. They'll tee it up and touch off the referee as well. Sporanovic needs to get it away, and Matt Ryan went for it, and the offside flag is up.
Well, I was waiting. Suspended animation for the touching to put his flag up because it was offside, but he was waiting until the player got involved.
Has he blown the whistle, the referee?
That's it!
That's it, they've done it! They have done it, Australia! History created with the blast of a referee's whistle. And 55 years after they first dared to dream of being part of the giant continent to the north, Australia are kings of Asia! Can you believe that? The misery of defeat in 2011 vanishes in a green and golden hue of delight 4 years on. And the golden generation may have brought us World Cup qualification, but the new breed has brought us a shiny silver trophy. And there's going to be some party in Sydney tonight. Well done, Ange Postecoglou.
Well done, Socceroos. They had to win it twice. Massimo Luongo with the opening goal on the cusp of half-time, and then Son Heung-min in stoppage time. And they were oh so brave, the Taiguk Warriors. But James Troisi, teed up by Tommy Urich, two substitutes and one young gun, winning the day for the green and gold. What a night. Australia, Asian champions, after beating South Korea by 2-1. And how good does that sound?